Iran has a new president. His name is Raisi. But who is he? Why was he chosen? How does that impact the people of Iran, and especially Christians? I'm going to answer all three questions now. Who is Raisi? He was the chief justice before this, but in the past, he was a murderer. He caused so many people to be killed. In the 1980s, he ordered the killing of tens of thousands of Iranians' opponents to the government. That included, of course, my younger brother, who was executed by the government of Iran. And then as a chief justice, he was cruel. He ordered cruelty against all those who opposed the government. That's why in Iran, he's called the butcher of Tehran. They call him President Lynch in Iran. And why was he chosen? Because of that. Because people of Iran have rejected Islam, they have rejected the government, and the government knows that they have lost the power, the controlling power over the hearts of the people of Iran. So they're turning to more and more violence. When you lose the heart of the people, the only way you can control them is by fear and violence. That's why he was chosen. By the way, he was chosen by the supreme leader. He was not elected. He was appointed by the supreme leader. The people did not want him. They did not even go out to vote. He was chosen because to tell the people of Iran, if you ever come on streets, we are going to be harsh on you. No more demonstrations. He is ready to kill maybe tens of thousands. He has a proven track record. So the government of Iran is giving a signal to the people of Iran, with this new president, you have even less freedom and don't even dare to protest. You're going to be killed. Now, how does that impact the people of Iran? Of course, first, they're going to be fearful. As we see, they're going to go into their homes for a while, but eventually they're going to come out even stronger and bolder because they cannot live longer under these circumstances. With oppression, with bad economy, they are to the end of their life. They say, what are we going to lose if we come on the streets? We're going to die? Okay, I'm ready to die. This is where Iranian people are going, to a point that living or dying doesn't matter to them. When they get to that point, coming on the streets and being killed is an option for them. And that's what the future of Iran is. Now, for persecution, of course, the persecution is going to increase. The only movement that can change Iran is the Christian movement. More and more of Iranians are coming to Christ. And the government knows that, is afraid of us Christians. They're afraid that we grow so big that we will change Iran. So the persecution of Christians will increase. And we need to pray. We need to pray for Iran. Number one, amazing time of salvation. With all that oppression, hopelessness, there is a new heaven open in Iran. And so many are coming to Christ. We are seeing so much result. Never seen it. The last 20 years we have been on the air has never been like this. The number of people are coming to Christ. Number two, we pray for Christians in Iran to grow in their faith and be bold and share the gospel with others and be salt and light even in that dark place. Would you join with us to help the persecuted Christians in Iran to be bold, to go out and to transform Iran by the power of the gospel? I want to thank those who pray for us, those who stand by us. Together, we are making a difference. God bless you.